It turns out that we may be able to understand what saber-toothed cats sounded like by looking at these tiny bones. These are cat hyoid bones. Saber-toothed cats went extinct during the last ice age. They're known for having really long canine teeth. While scientists don't know how exactly these cats used their teeth in hunting, we do know that they lived in woodland environments and were around the size of modern tigers. Tiny, fragile bones like these hyoid bones don't usually fossilize, but there's one place where many of these bones have been preserved. That place is the Rancho La Brea Tar Pits in Los Angeles, California. Here, sticky tar sits just below the surface of pools of water. During the Ice Age, animals would go to the water to get a drink and get trapped in the tar. This meant that a lot of bones entered the tar, and the tar did a great job of preserving them. So I wanted to understand more about saber-toothed cats and the ways that they interacted with their environment and other animals, but first I needed to learn more about modern cats. Humans have one hyoid bone. You may know it as the only bone in our body that doesn't articulate with any others. In humans and cats, hyoids help to anchor structures that we use to make sound, which are behind this cartilage here called the thyroid cartilage. So the shape of the hyoid bone may relate to vocalizations. Vocalizations are the sounds we make with our airways. You've probably heard a house cat purring or a tiger roaring, but you've never heard a house cat roar or a tiger purr, and that's because they're not actually capable of making those sounds. There are two groups of modern cats: pantherines, like lions, tigers, leopards, and jaguars, and felines, like domestic cats, bobcats, cougars, cheetahs, and caracals. Only felines can purr. Most pantherines roar. Saber-toothed cats predate the split between these groups, so they're as closely related to purring cats as they are roaring cats. These two groups of cats have differences in their hyoids. These are the hyoid bones of a caracal that haven't been fully cleaned yet. Because they're so small and blocked by other structures during dissection, the best way for me to show them to you is in a drawing. This is a drawing of a caracal, which is a purring cat. From this view, we can see five of its bones. This, on the other hand, is a drawing of a tiger, which is a roaring cat. It has the same bones as the caracal, but the epihyoid, which is pink in my drawings, doesn't ossify. This means that it's just a soft rope-like structure rather than a bone in these roaring cats. Many researchers think that this difference is what allows some cats to purr and some cats to roar, but snow leopards are an exception to this rule. They have an unossified epihyoid, but are unable to roar, so I wondered if there were any other differences. I started measuring hyoid bones, and it turns out that the shape of these two bones is different in roaring and purring cats, which is interesting because they're closest to the vocal structures behind the thyroid cartilage. I also measured 105 different saber-toothed cat hyoid bones. What I found was surprising. Because today our big cats, like lions and tigers, roar, many researchers expected saber-toothed cats to roar as well. But actually, while the size of their bones is larger than modern cats, the shape of their bones is more similar to purring cats. This may mean that saber-toothed cats were able to make sounds similar to your house cat, but at a lower pitch. Knowing this can help us understand more about cat evolution and what it was like during the Ice Age, but we also know a little bit more about these iconic but enigmatic saber-toothed cats.